हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ माय वीडियो नंबर 15 ऑन चैप्टर 3, दैट इज़ पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स। फॉर फाइंडिंग द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन स्टिल वी हैव सीन थ्री मेथड्स। फर्स्ट वन इज ग्राफिकल मेथड, सेकंड वन इज सब्स्टिट्यूशन मेथड एंड थर्ड वन इज एलिमिनेशन मेथड। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी लास्ट वन मोर मेथड, दैट इज क्रॉस मल्टीप्लिकेशन मेथड। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम, let us start this video. This is the general form of pair of linear equation in two variables, which is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. In cross multiplication method, first we write like this. First write x, after that y, and after that 1. And here a1, b1, c1, so start from middle. b1, c1 and after that a1. B1, C1, A1 and once again end with B1. Start from B1 and end with B1. So B1, C1, A1 and once again stop on B1. So B1, C1, A1 and once again stop at B1. Similarly, B2, start from B2. Second line, start from B2, C2, A2 and once again on B2. B2, C2, A2 and once again on B2. After that, x upon B1 multiplied by C2, B1 into C2 minus B2 into C1, B2 into C1 equal to y is equal to now y upon C1 A2 minus C2 A1, and last constant, which is 1 upon a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This method known as cross multiplication method. So this is the formula of cross multiplication method. When we want to use this formula, first we write our equations and compare with standard form a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0 and compare the coefficient of x and y. And after that, directly we write x upon b1 c2 minus b2 c1 equal to y upon c1 a2 minus c2 a1 equal to 1 upon a1 b2 minus a2 b1. Do not write like this. This is shown only, this method is cross multiplication method, because this is the cross b1 c2 minus b2 c1. So this method known as cross multiplication method. So in the process of solution, do not write this structure. Directly write this formula: x upon this, y upon equal to y upon this, and 1 upon that. You have to remember this formula. If you can't, then I have a trick to make this formula. See here, this is our general equation. a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. So in cross multiplication method, first you write like this: ab, bc and ca. ab, bc and ca write in cyclic order. This is cyclic. Cyclic means like a circle. ab, bc and ca, and start from middle, bc. So this is x upon, write bc upon bc. BC minus BC. After that, next is CA. So Y upon CA minus CA. CA minus CA. And last BC, CA, and last one is AB. So right here, AB upon AB. AB minus AB. AB minus AB. And after that, write 1, 2, 2, 1. 1, 2, 2, 1. 1, 2, 2, 1. This is 1, 2, and 2, 1. So use this action 1, 2, 2, 1 and get the formula. Look here, this is x upon b1 c2 minus b2 c1. Same here, b1 c2 minus b2 c1. Y upon c1 a2 minus c2 a1. C1A2 minus C2A1 and last one 1 upon A1B2 minus A2B1. A1B2 minus A2B1. So this is a technique for making formula. So try yourself. One more thing you may note here. In cross multiplication, here both constants C1 and C2 lies on left side. A1x plus B1y plus C1 equal to 0. Both constant lie on left side. So in this formula we have x upon b1 c2 minus b2 c1, y upon c1 a2 minus c2 a1 and 1 upon a1 b2 minus a2 b1. But if generally we see that constant c1 and c2 lie on right side like this, a1x plus b1y is equal to suppose c1, a2x plus b2y is equal to c1. Like this, one more equation I will write here. Suppose 2x plus 3y is equal to 5. So don't shift this constant on left side. Use this equation as it is, and this is suppose a1, this is b1 and this is c1, and in the formula only you make a change, write minus sign here. If both constants c1 and c2 write on right side, don't worry, lie on both constant right side, don't transfer into left side. Only you make a change, in place of plus 1 you write minus 1. So be conscious, if both constants are right lie on right side, then use here minus sign. And if both constant c1 and c2 lie on left side, then don't worry, use only plus 1. So remember this thing. Now we will see how to use this formula in question. So we start exercise 3.5, and first question is, which of the following pair of linear equation has unique solution, no solution or infinitely many solution, and in case there is a unique solution, find it by cross multiplication method. So we start from second question. Question number 2. 2x plus y equal to 5 and 3x plus 2y is equal to 8. So first we compare this equation with general form, that is a1x plus b1y equal to c1, not left side, on right side. Now a2x plus b2y equal to c2. So here a1 which is 2, b1 with coefficient of y, that is 1 only, so b1 is 1, not y, and c1 which is 5, don't transfer into left side, lie then on right side as it is. And a2 which is 3, b2 which is 2, and c2 that is 8. Now first we have to check if there is a unique solution, no solution or many solution. So first we find a1 upon a2, ratio between. So here a1 is 2 and a2 is 3, so a1 upon a2 that is 2 by 3. b1 upon b2 that is 1 by 2. Now observe, a1 upon a2 which is 2 by 3 and it is b1 upon b2 which is 1 by 2, both are not equal. So don't find c1 upon c2. So since here a1 upon a2 which is not equal to b1 upon b2, so it has unique solution. And our question is, if it is a unique solution, find it by cross multiplication method. So by cross multiplication method, our formula is x upon something, y upon something and 1 upon something, but here both constant c1 and c2 lie on right side, so use minus 1. And on rough side there is write AB, BC and CA, and you start from BC and write BC minus BC, after that CA minus CA and AB minus SB, BC minus BC, CA minus CA and AB minus AB, and use 1 2 2 1 1 2 2 1 1 2 2 1 and 1 2 2 1. So this is our formula of cross multiplication method, when both constant lie on right side, so use minus sign here. But once again be conscious, if both constants c1 and c2 lie on left side, use here plus 1. So don't be confused, here constant lie on right side. Now b1 c2 x upon b1 c2, so this is b1 c2, 1 into 8, this is 1 into 8, minus b2 c1, 2 into 5, this is 2 into 5, equal to y upon c1 a2, 5 into 3, so 5 into 3, minus c2 a1, this is c2 and a1, 8 into 2. This is 8 into 2 equal to minus 1 upon a1 b2 2 into 2 minus 3 into 1 2 into 2 minus 3 into 1. Now x upon 1 into 8, it means 8, 2 into 5, there is 10. Here y upon 5 into 3, that is 15, 8 into 2, 16, and here 2 into 2, 4, and 3 into 1, that is only 3. Now, difference of 8 and minus 10, that is minus 2, here 15 minus 16, that is minus 1, and here 4 minus 3, that is 1. And give equation number 1, 2, and 3. Now, first equation, second equation, and third equation, both are equal, both all three sides are equal, 1, 2, and 3. So, take first and third. First and third, because in third there is no constant, no variable. So by first and third and second and third. So first and third x upon minus 2 and third is minus 1 upon 1. Second and third y upon minus 1 and third is minus 1 upon 1. Now minus 2 transform on right side, so minus minus plus, so x is equal to only 2. And here minus minus, once again plus 1, so y is equal to 1. So this is our answer, x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1. This is the answer. So let's see one more question, fourth part of first question. X minus 3y minus 7 equal to 0 and 3x minus 3y minus 15 equal to 0. So compare this equation with standard form, a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. So here a1 which is only 1, coefficient of x, that is 1. b1 which is minus 3, this is minus 3. c1 which is minus 7, this is minus 7. a2 that is 3. b2 is minus 3. And c2 which is minus 15. Now we have to check there is unique solution, mini solution, or so no solution. So first find ratio between a1 upon a2, that is 1 by 3. Now b1 upon b2 minus 3 upon minus 3, minus sign cancel out, and 3 ones are 3, only 1 remaining. So here a1 upon a2 which is not equal to b1 upon b2, because 1 by 3 and 1 which is not equal, so do not find ratio between c1 upon c2. And conclude here this, since a1 upon a2 which is not equal to b1 upon b2, so it has unique solution. And if equation is unique solution, then find the value of x and y by cross multiplication method. So first write the formula of cross multiplication. So x upon something, y upon something, and 1 upon something. Once again be conscious here 1, both constant, c1 and c2 lie on left side, so in the formula use plus 1. And so on rough side, write AB, BC and CA, and start from BC. So X upon BC minus BC, Y upon CA minus CA, and after that AB minus AB. Start from BC minus BC, CA minus CA, and after that AB minus AB. So BC minus BC, CA minus CA, and AB minus AB, and use the action of 1 2 2 1, 1 2 2 1, 1 2 2 1, 1 2 2 1, and this is our formula of cross multiplication method. Now put the value of b1 c2 minus b2 c1. Be very conscious, b1 c2. Now check, where is b1, this is b1, b1 c2, it means minus 3 into minus 15, minus 3 into minus 15, this is minus sign. b2 c1, minus 3 into minus 7, minus 3 into minus 7 equal to y upon c1 a2, minus 7 into 3, let's see, minus 7 into 3, and this is minus sign. c2 a1, minus 15 into 1, minus 15 into 1 equal to 1 upon a1 b2, 1 into minus 3, this is 1 into minus 3, minus sign. a2 b1, 3 into minus 3, so this is 3 into minus 3. Now x upon minus minus plus, 15 into 3, 45, here minus sign is 3 times, 1 2 and 3, so minus minus again, once again it is minus. 7 into 3, 21. Here, minus 7 into 3, minus 21. Here, minus sign 2 times, so minus minus plus 15 into 1, that is 15. Here, minus 3, and once again, minus minus plus, so 3 into 3, 9. 45 minus 21, that is 24. Minus 21 plus 15, it means only minus 6. And minus 3 and plus 9, it means only 6. Give equation number 1, 2 and 3. Once again, by taking first and third, because in third there is no variable. So, first and third, you will get the value of x. So, x upon 24 equal to 1 by 6. This is third equation. 24 transfer on right side. So, x is equal to 24 upon 6. 6, 1 is 6 and 6, 4 is 24. So, x is equal to 4. Second and third, y upon minus 6 equal to 1 by 6. Minus 6 transfer to right side. So, y is equal to minus 6 upon 6. Cancel out, only minus 1 remaining. So, our answer is x is equal to 4 and y is equal to minus 1. Now, it is time for your homework. So, our question is once again, which of the following pair of linear equation has unique solution, no solution or infinitely many solutions? In case there is a unique solution, find it by using cross multiplication method. And your question is, first part, x minus 3y minus 3 equal to 0. And second equation, 3x minus 9y minus 2 equal to 0. And third part, 3x minus 5y equal to 20. And second equation, 6x minus 10y is equal to 40. And one more extra question, 5x plus 3y minus 35 equal to 0. And 2x plus 4y minus 28 equal to 0. So try this question. Okay, thank you for watching this video.